Tuberculosis, TB, how to assess a child. Sefu has been coughing for a few weeks, and John is assessing him as he may have tuberculosis or TB. If a child has been coughing for a long time, has other symptoms such as weight loss, or has been exposed to TB, it is important to assess them for TB. The assessment will include asking the child's caregiver questions about the child's symptoms. Number 1. Find out if the child has any symptoms of TB. You can ask if he has any of the following symptoms: a cough for 14 days or more, a fever lasting for 14 days or more, weight loss, tiredness and does not want to play, sweating at night. Children with any of these symptoms may have pulmonary TB and should be referred for testing and/or treatment. Number 2. Ask whether the child has been exposed to TB. You can ask, is anyone at home coughing or losing weight? Is there anyone at home or in the family with TB or on TB treatment? Has the child been in a closed space with many people, such as at a health facility or on public transport? Being exposed to TB or having a history of being in contact with active TB increases the risk of becoming infected. TB spreads easily in overcrowded, unventilated conditions. If anyone in the home may have TB or may be exposed to TB, they should be referred to a health facility for testing and/or preventative treatment. Lastly, number 3, find out if the child is living with HIV. You can ask, is the child at risk of HIV? Has he been tested for HIV? Is he living with HIV? HIV weakens the child's immune system, which increases their chances of getting TB. TB is also a common opportunistic infection in people living with HIV. Refer all children living with HIV for TB testing and ensure that they are tested annually. Also, refer all children with TB for HIV testing. Once you have asked the caregiver questions about the child's symptoms, you will look at the child for signs of TB. Look for signs of pulmonary TB such as fevers, cough or struggling to breathe, or any other danger sign. There are other important signs to look for when assessing for severe complications of TB or other types of TB: a headache and vomiting, or a stiff neck, or fits and convulsions. These can be signs of TB meningitis. It can develop quickly and have serious effects like blindness or death. Fevers and sudden back pain. These may indicate spinal tuberculosis from miliary or disseminated TB. Here, TB gets into the bloodstream and spreads all over the body. Signs of pulmonary or extrapulmonary TB are serious and the child needs to be referred urgently. Then, wait and measure the child. Check the child's growth curve and see if they are gaining weight. If the child appears malnourished, has poor growth, or is losing weight unexpectedly, this may be a sign of TB, which causes the body to need more calories. It is also important to note that underweight children may be more likely to be infected with TB due to a weak immune system. Once you have completed your assessment, you can decide if the child has signs of a mild, moderate or severe illness. Then you can decide if the child can be cared for at home or if they should be referred to a health facility for TB testing and medicine. Do you remember Sefu from the beginning of this video? John assessed him and found that in addition to a long-lasting cough, Sefu also had a fever for 2 weeks and was losing weight. John decided that it was likely that Sefu had pulmonary TB or TB in his lungs and so referred him urgently to a health facility for testing and treatment. Being able to recognize the types of TB and their signs and symptoms will help you determine if a child has TB. You can then refer them so that they can get the care they need.